This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Immigration and Nationality Act of 1965, H.R. 2580, P.U.B.L. 89-236, 79. 5 Long-Term Impact 6 See also 7 References 8 External Links Background The Hart-Celler Act of 1965 marked a radical break from the immigration policies of the past. Previous laws restricted immigration from Asia and Africa, and gave preference to Northern and Western Europeans over Southern and Eastern Europeans in the 1960s. The United States faced both foreign and domestic pressures to change its nation-based formula, which was regarded as a system that discriminated based on an individual's place of birth abroad. Former military allies and new independent nations aimed to delegitimize discriminatory immigration, naturalization and regulations through international organizations like the United Nations. In the United States, the national-based formula had been under scrutiny for a number of years. In 1952, President Truman had directed the Commission on Immigration and Naturalization to conduct an investigation and produce a report on the current immigration regulations. The report, whom we shall welcome, served as the blueprint for the Hart-Celler Act at the height of the civil rights movement of the 1960s. The restrictive immigration laws were seen as an embarrassment by, among others, President John F. Kennedy, who called the then quota system nearly intolerable. After Kennedy's assassination, President Lyndon Johnson signed the bill at the foot of the Statue of Liberty. The bill still prohibited the entry into the country of sexual deviants, including homosexuals. By doing so, it crystallized the policy of the INS to reject homosexual prospective immigrants on the grounds that they were mentally defective, or had a constitutional psychopathic inferiority. The Immigration Act of 1990 rescinded the provision discriminating against gay people. Provisions The Hart-Celler Act amended the Immigration and Nationality Act of 1952, McCarran-Walter Act. While it upheld many provisions of the Immigration Act of 1924, it maintained per-country limits, which had been a feature of U.S. immigration policy since the 1920s, and it developed preference categories. One of the main components aimed to abolish the national origins quota. This meant that it eliminated national origin, race, and ancestry as basis for immigration. It created a 7-category preference system, which gave priority to relatives of U.S. citizens and legal permanent residents and to professionals and other individuals with specialized skills. Immediate relatives and special immigrants were not subject to numerical restrictions. Some of the special immigrants include ministers, former employees of the U.S. government, foreign medical graduates, among others. For the first time, immigration from the Western Hemisphere was limited. It added a labor certification requirement, which dictated that the Secretary of Labor needed to certify labor shortages. Refugees were given the 7th and last category preference with the possibility of adjusting their status. However, refugees could enter the United States through other means as well, like those seeking temporary asylum. Immigration and Nationality Act, wages under foreign certification as per the rules under the Immigration and Nationality Act INA, U.S. organizations are permitted to employ foreign workers either temporarily or permanently to fulfill certain types of job requirement. The Employment and Training Administration ETA under the U.S. Department of Labor DAL is the body that usually provides certification to employers, forcing them to hire foreign workers in order to bridge qualified and skilled labor gap in certain business areas. Workers willing to perform a job in return of wages that either meet or exceed the present wage paid by the employers for the same occupation in the intended area of employment. However, some unique rules are applied to each category of visas. They are as follow: H-1B and H-1B-1 specialty professional workers should have a pay, as per the prevailing wage. An average wage that is paid to a person employed in the same occupation in the area of employment, or that the employer pays its workers the actual wage having similar skills and qualifications. H-2A agricultural workers should have the highest pay in accordance to the adverse effect wage rate AEWR, be the present rate for a particular crop or area, or see the state or federal minimum wage. The law also stipulates requirements like employer-sponsored meals and transportation of the employees, as well as restrictions on deducting from the worker workers' wages H-2B non-agricultural workers should receive a pay that is in accordance to the prevailing wage mean wage paid to a worker employed in a similar occupation in the concerned area of employment D-1 crewmembers longshore work should be paid the current wage mean wage paid to a person employed in a similar occupation in the respective area of employment permanent employment of aliens should be employed after the employer has agreed to provide and pay as per the prevailing wage trends and that it should be decided on the basis of one of the many alternatives provisioned under the said act. This rule has to be followed the moment the alien has been granted with permanent residency or the alien has been admitted in the United States so as to take the required position. Legislative history October 3, 1965, President Lyndon Johnson visits the Statue of Liberty to sign the Immigration and Nationality Act of 1965. The Hart-Celler Act was widely supported in Congress. Senator Philip A. Hart introduced the administration-backed immigration bill which was reported to the Senate Judiciary Committee's Immigration and Naturalization Subcommittee. Representative Emanuel Seller introduced the bill in the House of Representatives, which voted 320-70 in favor of the act. While the Senate passed the bill by a vote of 76-18 in the Senate, 52 Democrats voted yes, 14 no, and 1 abstained among Senate Republicans, 24 voted yes, 3 voted no, and 1 abstained in the House, 202 Democrats voted yes, 60 voted no and 12 abstained, 117 Republicans voted yes, 10 voted no and 11 abstained. 1 unknown representative voted yes. In total, 74% of Democrats and 85% of Republicans voted for passage of this bill. Most of the no votes were from the American South, which was then still strongly Democratic. During debate on the Senate floor, Senator Kennedy, speaking of the effects of the act, said, "Our cities will not be flooded with a million immigrants annually. Secondly, the ethnic mix of this country will not be upset." Michael A. Fayen and other conservative Democrats had insisted that family unification should take priority over employability, on the premise that such a weighting would maintain the existing ethnic profile of the country, that change in policy instead resulted in chain migration dominating the subsequent patterns of immigration to the United States and consequently a more ethnically diverse population. On October 3, 1965, President Lyndon B. Johnson signed the legislation into law, saying, "This system violates the basic principle of American democracy, the principle that values and rewards each man on the basis of his merit as a man. It has been un-American in the highest sense, because it has been untrue to the faith that brought thousands to these shores even before we were a country." Long-term impact. The proponents of the Hart-Celler Act argued that it would not significantly influence United States culture. President Johnson called the bill not a revolutionary bill. It does not affect the lives of millions. Secretary of State Dean Rusk and other politicians, including Senator Ted Kennedy, asserted that the bill would not affect U.S. demographic mix. However, the ethnic composition of immigrants changed following the passage of the law. Specifically, the Hart-Celler Act allowed increased numbers of people to migrate to the United States from Asia, Africa, the Middle East, and Southern and Eastern Europe. Prior to 1965, the demographics of immigration stood as mostly Europeans. 68% of legal immigrants in the 1950s came from Europe and Canada. However, in the years 1971 to 1991, immigrants from Hispanic and Latin American countries made 479% of immigrants, with Mexico accounting for 237% and immigrants from Asia 352%. Not only did it change the ethnic makeup of immigration, but it also greatly increased the number of immigrants. Immigration constituted 11% of the total U.S. population growth between 1960 and 1970, growing to 33% from 1970 to 80, and to 39% from 1980 to 90. The Latin American population overall has also dramatically increased since 1965, though this was more due to the various unexpected results of this act rather than due to this act itself. One of the main reasons was the introduction of immigration quotas to Latin America, whereas there were previously no immigration quotas for the Western Hemisphere. In the National Origins Formula, it is estimated that by the year 2042, white people not referring to themselves as Hispanic will no longer constitute a majority but rather only a plurality of the population of the United States. Minority groups, led by Hispanic Americans, mainly Mexican Americans, Black Americans, Asian Americans, Native Americans, and Pacific Islander Americans, would together outnumber non-Hispanic white Americans. Since the passage of the Immigration and Nationality Act of 1965, the new immigrants have encountered both opportunities and challenges. Many immigrants have been able to take advantage of the abundance of opportunities in the United States. However, immigrants also face hostility. Based on the rapid change of the United States' ethnic and cultural makeup, debates on the economic impact of immigration, and the presence of illegal immigrants see also Immigration Act of 1924. History of laws concerning immigration and naturalization in the United States. Lew Seller Act of 1946. Immigration and Nationality Act of 1952. National Origins Formula. References. A.B. Sarah Starkweather, U.S. Immigration Legislation Online. University of Washington, Bothell Library. Retrieved January 1, 2012. Carrot. Tracy J. Davis, Opening the Doors of Immigration, Sexual Orientation and Asylum in the United States, Human Rights Brief 6-3. Carrot. Gelton, Tom. 12 August 2015. Michael Fayon and LBJ, archived from the original on 6 May 2016. Retrieved 7 June 2016. Carrot. Massey, Douglas S. 25 September 2015. How a 1965 Immigration Reform Created Illegal Immigration. The Washington Post. ISSN. The Great Society. Congress v. Immigration to the United States and Related Topics. Relevant. Colonial Era, United States and International Laws. Colonial Era Nationality Law in the American Colonies. Plantation Act 1740. 18th Century Naturalization Act 1790. Immigration Act of 1882. Chinese Exclusion 1882. Scott Act 1888. Immigration Act of 1891. Geary Act 1892-1900-1949. Naturalization Act 1906. Gentlemen's Agreement 1907. Immigration Act of 1907. Immigration Act 1917. Asian Barred Zone. Emergency Quota Act 1921. Cable Act 1922. Immigration Act 1924. Tidings McDuffie Act 1934. Filipino Repatriation Act 1935. Nationality Act of 1940. Bracero Program 1942-1964. Magnuson Act 1943. War Brides Act 1945. Lew Seller Act 1946-1950-1999. UN-Refugee Convention 1951. Immigration and Nationality Act 1952. Visas and Policies. Visa Policy. Permanent Residence. Visa Waiver Program. Temporary Protected Status. Asylum. Green Card Lottery. U.S. Visit Security Advisory Opinion. E-Verify. Section 287. Grams. Government Organizations. Department of Homeland Security. Immigration and Customs Enforcement. U.S. Border Patrol. U.S. Customs and Border Protection. Immigration and Naturalization Service. INS. Board of Immigration Appeals. Supreme Court Cases. United States v. Wong Kim Ark 1898. United States v. Bhagat Singh Thind 1923. United States v. Brignoni Ponce 1975. Chamber of Commerce v. Whiting 2011. Related Issues and Events. Economic Impact. Guest Worker Program. Human Trafficking. Human Smuggling. Immigration Reform. Immigration Reduction. Labor Shortage. March for America. Illegal Immigrant Population. Reverse Immigration. 2006 Protests. Unaccompanied Minors from Central America. List of People Deported from the United States. Geography. Mexico. United States Border. Canada. United States Border. United States Border Patrol. Interior Checkpoints. Proposed Legislation. DREAM Act 2001-2010. Hour 4437-2005. McCain Kennedy 2005. SKIL 2006. Comprehensive Immigration Reform Act 2006. STRIVE Act 2007. Comprehensive Immigration Reform Act 2007. Uniting American Families Act 2000-2013. Border Security, Economic Opportunity, and Immigration Modernization Act of 2013. SAFE Act 2015. Immigration Stations and Points of Entry. Angel Island. Castle Garden. East Boston. Ellis Island. Sullivan's Island. Washington Avenue. Operations Wetback 1954. Peter Pan 1960-1962. Babylift 1975. Gatekeeper 1994. Endgame 2003-2012. Frontline 2004-2005. Streamline 2005-present. Return to Sender 2006-2007. State Legislation. California DREAM Act 2006-2010. Arizona SB 1070-2010. Alabama HB 56 2011. Non-Governmental Organizations. Coalition for Humane Immigrant Rights of Los Angeles. Coalition for Comprehensive Immigration Reform. National Immigration Forum. Center for Community Change. We Are America. Alliance. CASA of Maryland. Mexica Movement. Mexicans Without Borders. Federation for American Immigration Reform. Minuteman Project. Minuteman Civil Defense Corps. California Coalition for Immigration Reform. Save Our State. Center for Immigration Studies. National Korean American Service. Architectural Barriers Act, Child Nutrition Act, Civil Rights Act of 1964, Department of Housing and Urban Development, Department of Transportation, Economic Opportunity Act of 1964, Head Start Program, Job Corps, Elementary and Secondary Education Act, Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, Fair Housing Act of 1968, Food Stamp Act of 1964, Glassboro Summit, Gun Control Act of 1968, Higher Education Act of 1965, Upward Bound TRIO Teacher Corps, Immigration and Nationality Act of 1965, Johnson Doctrine, Dominican Republic Occupation, Medicare, Medicaid, Meritorious Service Medal, National Endowment for the Arts, National Endowment for the Humanities, Non-Discrimination in Federal Contracts, Executive Order 11375, Older Americans Act, Operation Chaos, Outer Space Treaty, Public Broadcasting Act of 1967, Vietnam War, Gulf of Tonkin Resolution, Credibility Gap, Vista Voting Rights Act of 1965, War on Poverty, White House Conference on Civil Rights, White House Preservation, State of the Union Address, 1966-1968, Cabinet Judicial Appointments, Supreme Court Controversies, Life, Early Years and Career, Operation Texas, Texas Broadcasting Company, Bashir Ahmad Legacy, Lyndon Baines Johnson Library and Museum, Lyndon B. Johnson National Grassland, Lyndon B. Johnson National Historical Park, Lyndon B. Johnson Space Center, Lyndon Baines Johnson Day, Lyndon B. Johnson School of Public Affairs, Memorial Grove on the Potomac, U.S. Postage Stamp Books, The Vantage Point, Perspectives on the Presidency, Bibliography, Elections, United States House of Representatives, Special Elections, 1937, United States House of Representatives Elections, 1938-1940-1942-1944-1946, United States Senate Special Elections, 1941, United States Senate Elections, 1948. 1954-1960, Democratic Party Presidential Primaries, 1960-1964-1968, Democratic National Convention, 1956-1960-1964, United States Presidential Election, 1960-1964, Popular Culture, Lyndon B. Johnson in Popular Culture, Daisy Advertisement, Johnson Cult, The Years of Lyndon Johnson, All the Way Film, LBJ Family, Claudia, Lady Bird, Taylor Johnson, Wife, Linda Bird Johnson, Rob, Daughter, Lucy Baines Johnson, Daughter, Samuel Ely Johnson Jr., Father, Rebecca Baines Johnson, Mother, Sam Houston Johnson, Brother, Samuel Ely Johnson Sr., Paternal Grandfather, Joseph Wilson Baines, Maternal Grandfather, Chuck, Rob, Son-in-law, John F. Kennedy, Richard Nixon, Category